Here comes Vanek, trying to steer it in front to Pominville, but it was intercepted. Vanek stole it back again. The rebound right in front of the net. And the penalty's got to be coming up here to cross-checking. I guess so.
Sabres end up getting a good chance, not on the initial rush, but on the turnover that took place. A great chance by Vanek, and there's the penalty. Teeminen, who ran Pominville into the net from behind.
Took the shot, blocked it, away goes Vanek. Connolly trying to catch up. Vanek gets in over the line. Here's Vanek cutting in front to Connolly. The shot deflected right on. And Biron makes the save. Another shot. Here's another shot. Oh, and what a save by Biron. And now we've got a meeting of the minds in front of the net.
That was a stop and a half, that one. Vanek throws it across to Connolly. He can't put it in, but look at the chance Connolly gets here. And what a save. It was 2 inches higher. It was in.
And again, got it out in front, but Sakara can't connect. And here's a penalty. The pass goes to center ice. In over the line. A breakaway for Richards. Took the shot. And it comes around to the boards. What a penalty coming up here.
Shots. Finneganov hooks the arm of Richards, and that's why we have a penalty shot. And of all the guys to give a penalty shot to, this guy is not the one.
Richards now picks up the puck on the penalty shot and comes in toward the Buffalo. Goes off the goal post. Go ahead, Patrick Kisit.
That's a save in Patrick's mind. The goal posts are part of the goalie's equipment. They'll tell, every one of them will tell you that.
Teeminen will leave it there. Brought in over the line by Richards. Cuts in front. The shot is scored. Richards banked it in off the pad or skate of Lalime. And Philadelphia with a power play goal has the lead.
It's goal number 28 for Richards. And he has been one of the kingpins for this Philadelphia team.
You know, Buffalo backed off there a little bit. Allowed him to penetrate to the middle of the zone on his forehand. Threw it at the net right on the ice. It's a very difficult puck to stop because Patty's got to think up top. Up top, side to side, and when you leave it right on the ice there, it's very difficult.
Vanek up on the wing. Pominville looking in front of the net. And
in the Buffalo zone, Vanek grabs the puck and away he goes, and it looks like nothing much is going to happen, and somehow Coburn let Vanek get the inside on him, and Vanek just tipped it through to beat Biron.
Moore keeping it in there. Dominic Moore still with the puck in the corner. Gances away. Coletta's shot at the side of the net. The rebound scores!
His first point as a Saber. It's a goal, not a pretty one, but a big one. Moore made a nasty little move to beat the Flyer defenseman, but then lost the puck, but got it back, and then goes to the net, and somehow it got between the skate and the goal post of Biron.
And Rivet eases it off the boards as Buffalo will make a change. Billy trying to come back again ahead to Carter. Carter gets leveled by Coletta. Richards took his shot, didn't get through. Teeminen holding it in there. And they try to work it in front. Back to Richards again. He cleared it in front. They score. Deflected in. And Philadelphia, another power play goal, has tied the game.
Simon Gagné got his stick on the Richards shot. It was almost a pass. And it changed directions right in front of Lalime. And Philadelphia's tied the game up.
Stafford stole it back. Came to the blue line. Kept in to Stafford again. Stafford shovels it right beside the net. Biron grabs it. Where's the puck? He's got it. No. It's in the net. Buffalo has the lead. 3-2.
Biron's complaining that the puck was under him and there should have been a whistle.
It is under review. However, it has been called a goal on the ice.
So they have to find evidence to cancel that. They can't listen for the whistle. The referee's already said it counts. So the whistle didn't go.
Puck was pushed into the net with a stick. Therefore, it is a good goal.
I think they might have thought Derek Roy kicked it in with a skate, but obviously he didn't.
Bringing it right back out again. Briere steering it in over the line. Ooh, that looked almost offside. Hashim going after it, tapping it back. He flicked it in front of the net. A whack at it. They score. Danny Briere was Johnny on the spot, and Philadelphia has tied it at 3.
Well, Briere, that's his first point since coming back after the second injury. And he hit it on the first hop after coming out from behind the net, so it wasn't a very pretty one.
Well, Philadelphia battles right back into a tie again. Here's Roy in front of the net, the shot right on, and Biron robs Stafford.
to center ice. Myers bring it in again with Richards. He cleared it into the slot. They score! And Briere got another one. He's got two in a row, and Philadelphia has the lead back again.
Well, Stafford had a wonderful opportunity to make it 4-3 Buffalo, and Veron makes a big-time save on him. And then Briere comes back, and from right in the middle of the slot, he beats Lalime with a good hard shot.
Roy trying to get away from Alberts, does, and swings it back to Pominville. Long shot. Walk in front. Rebound right in front of the net. Jumps up in the air. Veron couldn't grab it. Now in behind the net. Finally tried to get it in front. Becca Spachek's shot didn't get through. Pominville's backhand. That's knocked down. They whack at it again. And it finally steered off the boards and a frantic end to the second period. Tipped around on the boards to the blue line. And worked up to center. And here comes Philadelphia 2-on-1. In over the line. A pass right out in front. And the shot is taken up in the air. They score. Well, I'm not sure who's going to get credit for it. It might be Knoebel, but Philadelphia has the largest lead of the game, 5-3.
Well, if Knoebel got part of it, they're going to look at it again because this stick was pretty high.
Well, I think Knoebel did touch it. Ooh, and it might be high.
Oh.
I think that was hit with a high stick.
Well, I don't think there's any doubt that the stick was above the crossbar, but there is some doubt as to whether he hit it or not.
After video review, the play was ruled inconclusive. Therefore, the call on the ice stands. The puck was not high-sticked into the net. Good goal.
Well, the people in the seats that are looking at the replay on the video board don't agree with the people in Toronto who made the decision.
Back to Rivet. Rivet onto a Pinaganov. Pinaganov slides it beside the net. Moore came out in front, tried to jam it in, but Perron holds his ground. And now we've got a wrestling match. And Coburn and Moore mixing it up, and they're steered apart.
The Sabres are doing what they got to do. They got to get to Marty Perron. They got to get traffic in there. They got to continue to keep banging him. Fight for it, fight for it. It's exactly what they have to do.
Alberts to get it up to center ice for Gagne. Lalime had some difficulty behind the net. It came out in front, and the shot is right on. Lalime makes the save.
Well, he had to get up.
Knoebel had a great opportunity.
He had to get out from behind the net in a big hurry to make that save, because he went back behind the net to field the puck. It got caught at his feet. And the next thing you know, the puck's in front of the net. And Knoebel gets a shot as Lalime slides back into position.
Moving up, Spachek trying to hold it in. Hartnell knocked it away, and it goes to Tiemannin. Tiemannin slides it ahead. In over the line, Carter's got a break, and a shot. He scores! Carter rips it up over the shoulder of Lalime, and it's 6-3 Philadelphia.
And a lovely pass from Tiemannin off the boards, and that gets Carter behind Paille, and then he makes no mistake as Carter gets his 39th of the year with a rocket shot to the top.
Moore takes it back. Moore feeding it up to a Pinaganov in over the line. He goes to the outside, flipped it out in front, and the shot came. They score! Just as time expired in the game, the Sabres have scored.
Too little, too late.
And that is the first NHL goal for Butler, but it isn't much to get excited about.
So it's just a formality, dropping the puck. Indeed, they do so, and the Flyers leave the ice with a 6-4 victory.